Hey folks, something I've been putting off for some time is to extract many of the helpers that I've created during the ASP.NET Core from Zero to Overkill series and even others that come to mind, and putting it in a NuGet package that I can reuse, a NuGet package or more. So feels like the time to go ahead with it and extract some videos out of this process, because there are some interesting things we can do as we prepare these things. And the first thing I will go into is how to use Nuke, which is, like it says here, cross-platform build automation system with a C# DSL. So in the past I've talked about Cake, which has a similar concept. So we define our build pipeline using C#. So this time I'm going to use Nuke for the same reasons as I used Cake, because instead of doing the things in a script, doing it in C# is nicer. If the build is more complex, if the build is super easy, it's a bit overkill, but if the build is more complex, it's nice to use C#. And also, you might say, why don't you just use whatever is available in the CI/CD pipeline you use? In this case, I will use GitHub Actions. Well, the thing is, instead of depending a lot on it, if we extract it, we can run it locally, we can run it on GitHub Actions, we can run it on AppVeyor, Travis AI, whatever. We can run it anywhere. So that's why I like this. This time, I'm going to use Cake Nuke instead of Cake. For one, to try out something new, and also because even though Cake allows you to do things in C#, it requires some plugins and stuff like that. While Nuke does the same thing, but uses, basically it's a console application. So because we are writing a console application, we have built-in support from the IDEs, which can be a bit better than depending on the plugins like we do with Cake. So getting started, there are docs available, and there is this global tool, which I already installed, which provides us like an initial setup experience, which seems really good. So we're going to use this and follow it, and it will generate for us an initial build setup, which we can then customize and stuff like that. So let's head to the console. So this is the project. I have just one library project and the test project. So it's not something very complex, and it might be a bit overkill to use Nuke, but let's play around with it. So let's head to the terminal. Let me just do one thing here. So what do we do? Nuke setup. Nuke setup. So what will be the name of the project? Can be the default location. Let's use the latest stable version, should be the default solution. Yeah, that's the one. So let's use the default setup, which will give us already some steps of the pipeline ready, using .NET CLI. Our source folders are in src. Output, let's put it in artifacts. The tests are in tests. Git version, no, I'll use another tool. We'll see it later. But for now, skip it. Okay. So by doing this, we have some generated stuff. So we generated this build stuff, generated this Nuke file, which apparently has the solution in there. There's this build script, which are basically the bootstrappers. So in the terminal, we'll type build.ps1 if we are in PowerShell or SH in Bash, and it will run the build. Okay, so let's take a look. So if we go here and do a build.ps1 and run it, okay, so restore and compile worked. So let's take a look at what the code for this is. Let's go here. Don't annoy me. Okay, so we have a build class that inherits from nuke build, the main method, which calls execute, with the default, which is compile. Some of these things, so we have some helper, some things that will help us. So solution, configuration, repository. Repository is not used right now, but I imagine we'll use it because I imagine this has like information about the branch and stuff like that. So if we want to, depending on the branch, do something different. Then we have those things that we defined in the initial setup. Source directory, test directory, artifacts. And we have clean, which just deletes stuff. Deletes the bin and OBJ folders from the source and tests. Restore just calls .NET restore. And compile just calls .NET build. So these names, this is what it was meant with the DSL, so domain specific language. So we can immediately understand what's going on. So it's .NET build with the project solution, setting a configuration, which was defined over here, is local build or not, and enable no restore because restore was already done. And as you can see, we can set dependencies, so compile depends on restore, and that's why over here we see that restore was executed before compile. If we wanted to run, for instance, clean, we would do build clean, and it would run clean. Or we could do restore, and it would just run restore without compile. Okay, so this is the basic stuff. Now we can add our own stuff. Let me just make a change because this is using .NET Core 3, so let's use .NET 5. Let's do this again. So we have no longer those warnings. Nice. Now let's add some other steps. So we have clean, we have restore, we have compile. For sure, I want to run the unit tests, so let's add another one. I'm just copying this one just to be faster. And I want test. Test will depend on compile. And then we'll execute a .NET test. This is great because we can just write because we are expecting. So let me see, I want test. test.NET test. So it's really easy to figure out. As long as we have a general idea of what we want to achieve, we can type it out, and being a domain specific language, the names are more or less what we expect, and it's easy to find stuff. So .NET test, project file, configuration, no restore, and maybe we have enable no build. As we depend on compile, we don't need to build. So now if I head back to the command line and do build test. So we restore, compile, and it's running the tests. And we can see run the tests over here. So passed, fail. 33 passed, 0 skipped. Great. So we have test working, and as you saw, it's easy to define. As at least these simple steps, it's really easy to define. So another thing we want to do, because I want to create NuGet packages out of this, I want to create those packages. So again, let's copy these. Let's call it pack, because it's the name of the command. And I only want to pack after the tests. I want to be sure. And let's go here again, pack.net pack. So set project, don't know why, but apparently here instead of set project value is set project. We give it the solution. Configuration is the same. Let's say one thing I want is include symbols. So include set, include symbols. True. So the symbols is to allow some debug information to be packed with the NuGet package, so that the a user of the package can debug into the package, which might be useful to allow to understand if the problem is from the user's code or from the package code. And that's all. So let's try to run this. Build pack. Running the tests, and it's packing, and it packed, and we can see it created a package in repo stuff bin debug package. Okay, so this is not what we want, but we'll see. And it also generated a symbols package. But if you remember at the beginning, we said we want things to go into an artifacts folder, but it is putting it in over here in source bin debug. So we are missing one thing, which is going here, and we certainly have a set output directory. So sets the output directory, the build packages in the directory specified. And over here we have artifacts directory. So we can go here and do this. So let's go again here, pack again. And now it's over here, artifacts. So now it's in the correct place. So that is all I'm going to do today. In the next one, next video, I'll go with running this in GitHub Actions. So every time we do a pull request or do a commit or stuff like that, it will run and ensure everything is working. And later, I'll eventually add more steps to grab these NuGet packages and put them in a feed, so we can push them into NuGet.org itself. But that's when it's all running well. And we can also have an alternative feed, which we'll use to, for instance, every time we build the develop branch, it will push a package, like a beta package. So it's like a nightly build of the source. So we can use it to test, and if it's already everything working well, then we can actually create a release. But for this one, that's about it. And yeah, Nuke seems really easy to use, at least for these simple things. And because it's C sharp code, if we need some more complex stuff, we can just write C sharp code to solve those problems, like in Cake. So it's pretty cool. And hope you find it useful. But also take a look at Cake and maybe Fake. Fake is the equivalent, but for F sharp. So we have Nuke and we have Cake build or not. We have Cake build, which is similar to Nuke. And we also have Fake for F sharp, which again is something similar, but for F sharp. In fact, I think this was the first one and the others came later. But yeah, pretty cool stuff and easy to use. Really liked it. And that global tool with the initial setup, really easy to use. Great stuff. And if you're interested in this part of creating a NuGet package and having it run in CI/CD, keep checking on the channel because I'll be continuing this task. See you.